I'm Alexis Van Hurkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. In this lesson, we're going to take a look at how you can speed up your grading using smart filters. And smart filters rely on you having robust metadata entered for your clips. So before you start grading, let's go back to the media page, and I'm going to actually open up some of these video clips. And I'm going to select them, and in the metadata editor, I'm going to choose shot scene. This is a group of metadata that specifically provides fields for applying descriptions, shot numbers, scene numbers, take numbers, move information, and keywords. And keywords are a field that I use a lot because they allow you to enter information about each shot that can be useful later on when you're trying to figure out what you want to grade similarly. Each one of these clips, I've gone ahead and added metadata that would help me out as an editor and that will help me out as a colorist. When we get to the point where we're ready to do some color grading, let's see how we can use that metadata to help us out. So let's say I want to focus on just grading all of the shots with the female character in this scene, Asuka. If I go up to the clips button, just to the right, you'll see this downward arrow. This is the new filters pop-up. Now, timeline filters have been around for a long time. All of those filters have been moved into this pop-up. But down at the bottom, there's this new option, create smart filter. So if I choose that, and I'm going to call this Asuka, I can choose what criteria I want to filter by. And I've got all of my property categories in this long list. And I'm going to use the shot and scene information. And I'm going to use those keywords. So I'm going to choose keyword. I'll move this up. Contains, and I'm going to type the name. So now I've got all the Asuka shots lined up just like that. So if I want to focus on Asuka, there she is. If I want to sort these shots using C-sort, I now can, and they all get lumped right together. In fact, that's already happening. I can refine this. Let's say I only want to see the close-ups. I can click this plus button to add another category to filter by. By default, it uses the same metadata category and type that I had used before. So I'm just going to type in CU. So now I just have the Asuka close-ups. And I'm going to call this Asuka CU and click Create Smart Filter. So now whenever I just want Asuka's close-ups, I can choose Asuka CU, and now I'm filtering by those criteria. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new smart filter, and I'm going to create one for the other character whose name is Delmar, D-E-L-M-A-R. I'm going to call this Delmar. I'm going to create that smart filter. So now I can quickly switch back and forth between these two sets of clips as I go through and make sure that I grade them all so that each shot in each location looks similar to one another. And having done this, there are other options to rename these smart filters after the fact, re-edit them, or delete them once I decide I don't need them anymore. It's a really great technique. There are lots of things you can use this for. Basically, whenever you want to isolate a particular type of clip in your project, all you have to do is be clever about what metadata you're using. I hope this has been useful for you. Thanks a lot for watching. My name's Alexis Van Hurkman. If you want more information on grading in DaVinci Resolve or using DaVinci Resolve in any capacity, go check out my titles at rippletraining.com. Thanks a lot.